my new novel. It's just come out in France. Came out in April. It's a love story. It's about a man who loses his wife at the beginning of the book, and he loves her, and he wants her back. And the book is his search for her. But because of the kind of writer I am, it's not a simple search. And it crosses a century of time, two wars, several countries, and a lot of discursive prose. Well, I first got interested in magicians when I wrote The Prestige, which I wrote about 20 years ago. And then the idea was that what a magician does is very like what a writer does, that you work in secret. All the work you really do, nobody ever sees. Magicians practice for years, and then they go on stage and do the trick. And writers work for 3 years, produce a manuscript, and the book comes out, and it's easy, it's finished. Because in fact, the real work is hidden. And also, I'm very interested in storytelling, and magic tells a story. They sort of show you something, and then they make it do something else, and then there's a twist at the end. That's the appeal. People always enjoy magic. If you go to a magic show, it's people laughing all the time. And a good story has that same effect. He wrote most of his books, we now remember, as science fiction in the 19th century. The first five or six books were all written before 1900. And they're all the famous ones, The Time Machine, War of the Worlds, The Invisible Man. And he was a young man. He was, H.G. Wells was about 30 when he wrote these books. And he was poor, and he invented science fiction. That way, books like that had been written before, but he wrote them so well and made them so popular. People identified that sort of story with him. If we go forward, 50, 60 years, you get me, and I started writing, and there was already a science fiction genre, mostly created by American writers. And I always felt uncomfortable with that because it was very restricting. American writers, very orthodox. They have rules. You can do this, you can't do that. And I found that, as a writer, a bit discouraging. And so I was thinking one day, what could I do about this? And I was thinking back to how Wells had written. And he just basically wrote books from general principles. He didn't have any knowledge of science fiction at all. So, excuse me, I was trying to, in a sense, reinvent myself so that I could forget what I knew about science fiction and try and write it fresh. And ever since then, I've done that. So for me, H.G. Wells is the great mentor. It began with one short story. I wrote a short story 40 years ago. And I really liked the background of the islands. And it seemed to me to be a sort of tapestry, a background. And it's something I could use again and again as a sort of background for short stories. And then I got ideas for doing novels in it. And gradually the islands have become more and more important. And there's the book before this was called Les Insulaires. And it's called which was 53 of the islands. Each one has its own story. And so gradually the islands themselves are coming forward as the main characters, although, of course, the people are still important. The novel I'm working on at the moment is, again, in the islands. I'm really happy there. it's like going to Paris. Probably three of mine. For different reasons. Le Monde Inverti is the most popular. I don't know why, everyone loves it. And it was the first book I wrote thinking about trying to think like H.G. Wells, that, I was saying earlier about trying to reinvent. And it was the first book I wrote trying to reinvent science fiction for myself, not for other people. Then I would suggest The Prestige. because it was made into a film, so it's easily accessible. The book is quite different from the film. A lot better. It's a lot longer. And I think I would suggest The Adjacent as my most recent, because it's the most serious, it's the most complicated, but it's also, I hope, the most enjoyable, because it, as you get towards the end, you realise what's going on. And as a certain climax to it, which I'm quite keen on. I wouldn't change anything. I remember Woody Allen once said that if he lived his life again, he would do everything the same, except he wouldn't go and see the film with the Magus. I wouldn't smoke. I smoked for a while. I wouldn't do that. I wouldn't change anything. I've had a nice life, and interesting, and I spent most of my life broke, no money, but that was all right. Got a lot of nice friends.